Heart failure, Wikipedia audio. Heart failure, often referred to as congestive heart failure, occurs when the heart is unable to pump sufficiently to maintain blood flow to meet the body's needs. Signs and symptoms commonly include shortness of breath, excessive tiredness, and leg swelling. The shortness of breath is usually worse with exercise, while lying down, and may wake the person at night. A limited ability to exercise is also a common feature. Chest pain, including angina, does not typically occur due to heart failure. Common causes of heart failure include coronary artery disease, including a previous myocardial infarction, high blood pressure, atrial fibrillation, valvular heart disease, excess alcohol use, infection, and cardiomyopathy of an unknown cause. These cause heart failure by changing either the structure or the functioning of the heart. There are two main types of heart failure: heart failure due to left ventricular dysfunction and heart failure with normal ejection fraction, depending on whether the ability of the left ventricle to contract is affected, or the heart's ability to relax. The severity of disease is usually graded by the degree of problems with exercise. Heart failure is not the same as myocardial infarction or cardiac arrest. Other diseases that may have symptoms similar to heart failure include obesity, kidney failure, liver problems, anemia, and thyroid disease. The condition is diagnosed based on the history of the symptoms and a physical examination with confirmation by echocardiography. Blood tests, electrocardiography, and chest radiography may be useful to determine the underlying cause. Treatment depends on the severity and cause of the disease. In people with chronic stable mild heart failure, treatment commonly consists of lifestyle modifications such as stopping smoking, physical exercise, and dietary changes, as well as medications. In those with heart failure due to left ventricular dysfunction, angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers along with beta blockers are recommended. For those with severe disease, aldosterone antagonists or hydralazine with a nitrate may be used. Diuretics are useful for preventing fluid retention. Sometimes, depending on the cause, an implanted device such as a pacemaker or an implantable cardiac defibrillator may be recommended. In some moderate or severe cases, cardiac resynchronization therapy or cardiac contractility modulation may be of benefit. A ventricular assist device or occasionally a heart transplant may be recommended in those with severe disease that persists despite all other measures. Terminology. Heart failure is a common, costly, and potentially fatal condition. In 2015, it affected about 40 million people globally. Overall, around 2% of adults have heart failure, and in those over the age of 65, this increases to 6-10%. Rates are predicted to increase. In the year after diagnosis, the risk of death is about 35%, after which it decreases to below 10% each year. This is similar to the risks with a number of types of cancer. In the United Kingdom, the disease is the reason for 5% of emergency hospital admissions. Heart failure has been known since ancient times, with the Ebers Papyrus commenting on it around 1550 BCE. Heart failure is a physiological state in which cardiac output is insufficient to meet the needs of the body and lungs. The term congestive heart failure is often used, as one of the common symptoms is congestion, or buildup of fluid in a person's tissues and veins in the lungs or other parts of the body. Specifically, congestion takes the form of water retention and swelling, both as peripheral edema and as pulmonary edema, as well as ascites. This is a common problem in old age as a result of cardiovascular disease, but it can happen at any age, even in fetuses. The site of the heart involved. Right heart failure compromises pulmonary flow to the lungs. Left heart failure compromises aortic flow to the body and brain. Mixed presentations are common. Left heart failure often leads to right heart failure in the longer term, whether the abnormality is due to insufficient contraction, or due to insufficient relaxation of the heart, or to both, whether the problem is primarily increased venous back pressure, or failure to supply adequate arterial perfusion, whether the abnormality is due to low cardiac output with high systemic vascular resistance or high cardiac output with low vascular resistance, the degree of functional impairment conferred by the abnormality, the degree of coexisting illness, i.e. heart failure slash systemic hypertension, heart failure slash pulmonary hypertension, heart failure slash diabetes, heart failure slash kidney failure, etc. The term acute is used to mean rapid onset, and chronic refers to long duration. Chronic heart failure is a long-term condition, usually kept stable by the treatment of symptoms. Acute decompensated heart failure is a worsening of chronic heart failure symptoms which can result in acute respiratory distress. High output heart failure can occur when there is an increased cardiac output. The circulatory overload caused can result in an increased left ventricular diastolic pressure which can develop into pulmonary congestion. Heart failure is divided into two types based on ejection fraction, which is the proportion of blood pumped out of the heart during a single contraction. Ejection fraction is given as a percentage with the normal range being between 50 and 75%. The two types are 1. Heart failure due to reduced ejection fraction. This type is also known as heart failure due to left ventricular systolic dysfunction or systolic heart failure. This type of heart failure occurs when the ejection fraction is less than 40%. 2. Heart failure with preserved ejection fraction. This type is also known as diastolic heart failure or heart failure with normal ejection fraction. This type of heart failure occurs when the heart muscle contracts well but the ventricle does not fill with blood well in the relaxation phase. Heart failure symptoms are traditionally and somewhat arbitrarily divided into left and right-sided, recognizing that the left and right ventricles of the heart supply different portions of the circulation. However, heart failure is not exclusively backward failure. Class I, no limitation is experienced in any activities, there are no symptoms from ordinary activities. Class II, slight, mild limitation of activity, the patient is comfortable at rest or with mild exertion. Class III, marked limitation of any activity, the patient is comfortable only at rest. Class IV, any physical activity brings on discomfort and symptoms occur at rest. There are several other exceptions to a simple left-right division of heart failure symptoms. Additionally, the most common cause of right-sided heart failure is left-sided heart failure. The result is that patients commonly present with both sets of signs and symptoms. The left side of the heart is responsible for receiving oxygen-rich blood from the lungs and pumping it forward to the systemic circulation. Failure of the left side of the heart causes blood to back up into the lungs, causing respiratory symptoms as well as fatigue due to insufficient supply of oxygenated blood. Common respiratory signs are increased rate of breathing and increased work of breathing. Rattles or crackles, heard initially in the lung bases, and when severe, throughout the lung fields suggest the development of pulmonary edema. Cyanosis, which suggests severe low blood oxygen, is a late sign of extremely severe pulmonary edema. Stage A, patients at high risk for developing HF in the future but no functional or structural heart disorder. Stage B, a structural heart disorder but no symptoms at any stage. Stage C, previous or current symptoms of heart failure in the context of an underlying structural heart problem, but managed with medical treatment. Stage D, advanced disease requiring hospital-based support, a heart transplant or palliative care. Signs and symptoms. Additional signs indicating left ventricular failure include a laterally displaced apex beat and a gallop rhythm may be heard as a marker of increased blood flow or increased intracardiac pressure. Heart murmurs may indicate the presence of valvular heart disease, either as a cause or as a result of the heart failure. Backward failure of the left ventricle causes congestion of the lungs' blood vessels, and so the symptoms are predominantly respiratory in nature. Backward failure can be subdivided into the failure of the left atrium, the left ventricle, or both within the left circuit. The patient will have dyspnea on exertion and, in severe cases, dyspnea at rest. Increasing breathlessness on lying flat, called orthopnea, occurs. It is often measured in the number of pillows required to lie comfortably, and in orthopnea, the patient may resort to sleeping while sitting up. Another symptom of heart failure is paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, a sudden nighttime attack of severe breathlessness, usually several hours after going to sleep. Easy fatigability and exercise intolerance are also common complaints related to respiratory compromise. Cardiac asthma or wheezing may occur. Compromise of left ventricular forward function may result in symptoms of poor systemic circulation such as dizziness, confusion, and cool extremities at rest. Right-sided heart failure is often caused by pulmonary heart disease, which is usually caused by difficulties of the pulmonary circulation, such as pulmonary hypertension or pulmonic stenosis. Physical examination may reveal pitting peripheral edema, ascites, and liver enlargement. Jugular venous pressure is frequently assessed as a marker of fluid status, which can be accentuated by eliciting hepatojugular reflux. If the right ventricular pressure is increased, a parasternal heave may be present, signifying the compensatory increase in contraction strength. Backward failure of the right ventricle leads to congestion of systemic capillaries. This generates excess fluid accumulation in the body. This causes swelling under the skin and usually affects the dependent parts of the body first. Nocturia may occur when fluid from the legs is returned to the bloodstream while lying down at night. In progressively severe cases, ascites and liver enlargement may develop. Significant liver congestion may result in impaired liver function, and jaundice and even coagulopathy may occur. Left-sided failure. Right-sided failure. Dullness of the lung fields to finger percussion and reduced breath sounds at the bases of the lung may suggest the development of a pleural effusion. Though it can occur in isolated left or right-sided heart failure, it is more common in biventricular failure because pleural veins drain into both the systemic and pulmonary venous systems. When unilateral, effusions are often right-sided. Adhere tree rule indicates that patients with blood urea nitrogen 35 from the CPX test. The heart failure survival score is a score calculated using a combination of clinical predictors and the VO2 max from the cardiopulmonary exercise test. Monitoring. Heart failure is associated with significantly reduced physical and mental health, resulting in a markedly decreased quality of life. With the exception of heart failure caused by reversible conditions, the condition usually worsens with time. Although some people survive many years, progressive disease is associated with an overall annual mortality rate of 10%. Approximately 18 of every 1,000 persons will experience an ischemic stroke during the first year after diagnosis of HF. As the duration of follow-up increases, the stroke rate rises to nearly 50 strokes per 1,000 cases of HF by 5 years. Classification. In 2015, heart failure affected about 40 million people globally. Overall, around 2% of adults have heart failure, and in those over the age of 65, this increases to 6-10%. Above 75 years old, rates are greater than 10%. Rates are predicted to increase. Increasing rates are mostly because of increasing lifespan, but also because of increased risk factors and improved survival rates from other types of cardiovascular disease. Heart failure is the leading cause of hospitalization in people older than 65. Algorithms. Framingham criteria. In the United States, heart failure affects 5.8 million people, and each year 550,000 new cases are diagnosed. In 2011, congestive heart failure was the most common reason for hospitalization for adults aged 85 years and older, and the second most common for adults aged 65-84 years. It is estimated that 1 in 5 adults at age 40 will develop heart failure during their remaining lifetime, and about half of people who develop heart failure die within 5 years of diagnosis. Heart failure is much higher in African Americans, Hispanics, Native Americans, and recent immigrants from the Eastern Bloc countries like Russia. This high prevalence in these ethnic minority populations has been linked to high incidence of diabetes and hypertension. In many new immigrants to the U.S., the high prevalence of heart failure has largely been attributed to lack of preventive health care or substandard treatment. Nearly 1 out of every 4 patients hospitalized in the U.S. with congestive heart failure are readmitted within 30 days. Additionally, more than 50% of people seek readmission within 6 months after treatment, and the average duration of hospital stay is 6 days. Congestive heart failure is a leading cause of hospital readmissions in the U.S. People aged 65 and older were readmitted at a rate of 24.5 per 100 admissions in 2011. In the same year, Medicaid patients were readmitted at a rate of 30.4 per 100 admissions, and uninsured patients were readmitted at a rate of 16.8 per 100 admissions. These are the highest readmission rates for both patient categories. Notably, congestive heart failure was not among the top 10 conditions with the most 30-day readmissions among the privately insured. In the UK, has despite moderate improvements in prevention, heart failure rates have increased due to population growth and aging. Overall, heart failure rates are similar to the 4 most common causes of cancer combined. People from deprived backgrounds are more likely to be diagnosed with heart failure and at a younger age. ESC algorithm. Differential diagnosis. Prevention. Management. Acute decompensation 2. Chronic management. Lifestyle. Medication. Minimally invasive therapies. Surgical therapies. Palliative care. Prognosis. Epidemiology. United States, United Kingdom, Developing World. In tropical countries, the most common cause of HF is valvular heart disease or some type of cardiomyopathy. As underdeveloped countries have become more affluent, there has also been an increase in the incidence of diabetes, hypertension, and obesity, which have in turn raised the incidence of heart failure. Men have a higher incidence of heart failure, but the overall prevalence rate is similar in both sexes since women survive longer after the onset of heart failure. Women tend to be older when diagnosed with heart failure. They are more likely than men to have diastolic dysfunction, and seem to experience a lower overall quality of life than men after diagnosis. In 2011, non-hypertensive congestive heart failure was one of the 10 most expensive conditions seen during inpatient hospitalizations in the U.S., with aggregate inpatient hospital costs of more than $10.5 billion. Heart failure is associated with a high health expenditure, mostly because of the cost of hospitalizations. Costs have been estimated to amount to 2% of the total budget of the National Health Service in the United Kingdom, and more than $35 billion in the United States. There is low quality evidence that stem cell therapy may help. Although this evidence positively indicated benefit, the evidence was of lower quality than other evidence that does not indicate benefit. A previous claim, which came from a 2012 article published by the British journal Heart, stated that a low-salt diet increased the risk of death in those with congestive heart failure. This claim has since been withdrawn. The paper was retracted by the journal in 2013 because two of the cited studies contained duplicate data that could not be verified, and the data have since been lost. A 2016 Cochrane review found tentative evidence of longer life expectancy and improved left ventricular ejection fraction in persons treated with bone marrow-derived stem cells. Sex. Economics. Research directions.